Welcome to Shadow for the Broker 112, something I've called Phantom Shadows. Let's go with who is playing today. Ben, if you want to start off.
Sure. I'm playing Bunker, who's a experimental battle droid prototype for the Alliance. He's a big, round-shouldered, no-headed droid with a smiley face spray-painted on his chest.
Jack.
I'm playing Akron Duvel, a noble in exile who is dealing with some personal troubles regarding his very estranged family.
Ooh. D.
I am playing Dara, a gunslinging chess pilot. She's found some information about her family, which now leads her to attempting to decipher this data pack.
Tommy.
I'm playing Ragesh Vai, the man formerly known as Captain Compnor, an elite ISB agent who also disguised himself as a Holovid star. He is now an Imperial defector and a proud member of the Rebellion.
And Dan.
I'm playing Aiden. He's a Corellian Fringer pilot and is a bit of a hotshot in the most recent few sessions. He recently piloted a spaceship with his feet.
Oh, wow.
Well, then.
Any particular avoided reason? Because he was showboating. You know,
something
he liked to do.
Well, then. Okay, so as we start off the mission, the five of you are meandering around Alter Mountain Base. What kind of stuff would your characters be up to at the moment?
Feeding Singe.
Dara would be looking at the recording again and thinking when would be a good time to delve deeper into the repository she received.
If Bunker's not being worked on by Nog, he's just patrolling the base, making sure everyone's safe and there are no Imperial infiltrators about trying to assassinate anyone.
Aiden will be looking over recent shipments of supplies in and out of the base and everything like that. Making sure everything's running smoothly.
Macron, we're actually currently resting.
Just taking a nice nap.
In the brig.
He has his own private cell now.
Oh. He can say hi to a tie. He's still over there. While in the base, there's an emergency transmission, and you know the different sort of jingles that go with emergency transmissions, and you can tell that this one is from Wayright, from Dox. And as you gather to listen to it, it seems like you are the agents that seem to be that are managing the base at the moment. It's just a holo recording, and it's asking you to go to the town hall and Wayright. Dox is pretty vague. He mentions that the town is calling a meeting about security concerns.
So before we get there, should we roll resources?
It's probably a good idea. What do we have?
62 would be Dara's family.
Wow, 46 2 weeks on the shot! 2 weeks in a row!
Yeah, so the recent findings is really distracting Dara, and so it's putting a lot of strain on you at the moment. And how did duty go?
It went over.
Okay. That's sad. Poor duty.
It tends to go over most weeks.
Okay, everyone addressed your strain thresholds. Mm-hmm. Before we move on. Okay, everyone good?
Good here.
So any questions, anything you'd like to do before you just go ahead and head to Wayright?
I mean, normally Ragesh would, but it's Dox. He's one of the few. If he asks for help, Ragesh isn't really going to ask too many questions. He'll just, you know, he'll get there ASAP.
Yeah, there's not...
he's a friend.
Yeah, and he's not a... It's not something you'd be able to ask questions directly to either. It's just a recording, sort of a message that he was sent.
I guess the one thing that... And I don't know if this would be possible mechanically, but would there be a way to do a streetwise roll, but this is more of what Ragesh had noticed the last time he had been in town to see if there had been anything that piqued his interest or seemed out of place?
Sure. Let's just make that an average streetwise check to just as you guys are entering Wayright to get a sense of the mood of the town at the moment.
Aiden will assist on that. I don't know what regress is streetwise is role, but probably high.
Wayright has turned into a fairly bustling town. But the streets are pretty empty at the moment. You see people heading into the direction of the town hall. It seems like there's a lot of energy at the moment. And the people that you can see seem nervous. There's some that seem angry. Something is going on that's made the town very aggravated.
Do they seem as angry as they were back in the days of Grey's Anatomy?
No, it doesn't seem like that kind of tension. It seems more, what you can gather, there's something external.
Okay.
So, you actually make it over to the town hall. I didn't get to load all the tokens in here, but so it's not so much a mob at the moment. It's more of an angry crowd. So you enter into the town hall, which is a fairly small building, and it's pretty crowded. There's not much space for you guys. You see various members of the population here. You see a lot of miners. You see a representative from the Zygerians, a representative from the Evokai. You see Weshir from the Wookiees. Most of the crowd seems to be shouting back and forth about how they're going to deal with what's happening. You see Dox at the front, and once he notices that you enter, he begins to speak. There have been some cause for security concerns lately, so I called this meeting. A loud young miner interrupts. Criff your meeting! We've seen stormtroopers!
What?
We're getting a gang together and lynching those Imperial bastards.
Well,
a section of the audience erupts in cheers. Dox seems oddly composed, even at the mention of Imperials. There's been no verification that the Empire is on Wayright. No transmissions, no ships, no attacks. The audience quiets a bit, but the mood is still tense.
It's a bunch of punk cosplayers.
We have the 501st cosplayers on there.
501. Many of you may recognize my friends at the back. I've brought them here to investigate these sightings. A miner that the party may recognize as a leader of the miners, Harkira, interrupts. We can handle this ourselves. We don't need to go begging these mercenaries to crawl out of whatever coal they hide in to defend our town. Who's with me? And cheers erupt from the crowd again. Dox sort of looks back at the agents, wanting to assist in calming what seems to be a lynch mob that's forming.
Shouldn't we at least prove they're even here first?
Yeah.
We can't hear anything over the crowd, right?
No.
Right, okay, Dara will draw her blaster and fire
wait,
off
wait,
into
wait,
the
no,
air.
No, you can hear.
Okay.
Wait.
Okay. She goes, whoa, hold your horses. We live here too. Okay, we may be far away, but most of you do have
Where do you live? We don't see you around here.
Yeah, though we don't... Ultra Mountain's a secret.
Yeah, we live in the back. Yeah, well, some of you've got my comm link, which I gave to you guys some time ago. All you had to do was give me a shout.
Okay.
You can usually catch me teeing off in the morning over at the casino.
What have you done to protect us? Well, we don't need your protection either.
Quite a lot, actually.
You see that some parts of the crowd, including, it seems like there are different instigators in the crowd that are happening. You actually do hear a sort of a Wookiee roar that's sort of echoing the anger of the crowd. We're going to go into sort of a social battle here. Can I get everyone to roll initiative?
So this would be cool, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Cool on your side.
I mean, obviously we saw this crowd from a mile away.
Yeah, exactly. So the people you seem that seem to be gathering, there's Hakira, sort of the minor leader. Shoalbear, the Wookiee, seems to be instigating for the Wookiee side. You see Svenna sort of dismayed at what's going on. She seems to be a bit more calm than Shoalbear. It doesn't look like she's happy about the situation either. So, okay. A double triumph. That's interesting.
Yeah, Dara's using her rapid reaction. So that's what I'm going to... here I am.
So, the way this is going to work is that you're basically going to be fighting for the will of the crowd. So your opponents are trying to rile up the crowd to get it going. They're going to be causing strain to the crowd. And what your attacks are going to be doing are trying to reduce that strain. Or you can do whatever you want. You can rile up the crowd too if you think that'll be helpful.
Okay.
It's really your options at this point. It does look like Dox is wanting the crowd to be calmed, but you can make that choice on your own. You do see someone else in the room that some of you recognize. Secondhand Lao. You know him as an arms dealer.
Better not have that ship dealer that Aiden ran into in here.
Okay, so has everyone rolled? It looks like it. Okay, let me roll. So I'm going to have four people. There's one. Oh, wow.
That's a lot of successes.
It is. Looks like some people were more prepared.
I can only imagine that's the Wookiee.
It's a pretty good guess. So, because this is not standard triumph, I'll let you hold triumphs to upgrade your next, or you can send those to us upgrades to other people. Okay. So, Ragesh's triumphs you can send two upgrades or reserve two upgrades for yourself.
Alrighty. Yikes.
Okay, so this is kind of dangerous, guys, because they might be able to push the crowd over before you even get a chance to talk.
We'll see, I guess.
So this is a set difficulty against the crowd for everyone. It's going to be two red and a purple, but you can, of course, upgrade against them. Actually, the first person to speak is Secondhand Lao. You know, those mercenaries over there, we don't know who they work for. We don't know what they're up to. They're just sort of here, occasionally. You know, with all the work going around on the war, Who's to say they aren't with the Empire, too? And so whispers go about the crowd, about you, everyone working with the Empire. And so, obviously, he is trying to use deception here.
Yeah.
Okay. D, I think we're the mercs.
Yeah, it'd be fun.
Okay, just making sure you were aware.
Okay.
Okay, Macron would like to interject.
Okay, go ahead.
He'll speak up and say, "We have done so much for this town. I do not believe the mystery surrounding where we come from or where we go is something that's really worth addressing. Who cares? I think some of us stay in that damn casino I've seen so many of you at." And he just points over to the mother load. He knows where it is. All right, so this is a set difficulty, but you can add setback or boost if you want.
I'm going to add a boost and a setback. The mood, everyone recognizes the work that you guys have done, but there's, after what Hikira said about self-reliance, there's almost a, we need to stand up and start doing shit for ourselves here.
All right, I'm going to flip. Okay, I'm going to use all these spare successes to add, I don't know, 4 failures. And I'll spend the 2 advantage to add 2 threat to his roll.
Nice.
Okay. So you can either spend threats to put a setback onto their roll, or,
I can use successes to change, if this was a friendly check, I could move those successes over to their thing, or I can change those successes to failures on their roll.
Okay.
Or I can, and for advantages, I can change those to either advantages for the other roll or threats to the other roll.
Okay. So you're going to negate 2 of the successes, so the damage he would have done to the crowd. It seems like with that interjection, the crowd is like, that didn't really make a lot of sense. I don't know about that. That's kind of a weird thing for him to say. And so he still has 2 threats at the end, and then you have 3 more successes you can spend then?
I can't really change those successes to anything other than failure, so...
Okay.
That'll be it.
Okay. So he'll have a setback on the next time he rolls. Try and make me enforce that. Okay. So the crowd doesn't seem to be accepting that lie from secondhand Lao. But actually, Svenna, the elderly Zygerian leader, speaks up. And she actually begins by saying, "The Empire is deadly. I was on the surface of Zygeria when the bombardment began. I saw the buildings toppling, the people being vaporized in the streets from the beams. If there's any part of the Empire that's here, it needs to be rooted out immediately."
And Dara will then say,
"No,
yeah,
you have to wait for your turn. We're in social combat." So she's going to be rolling coercion, but a little more muted of a coercion. Okay.
I would also like to interject here.
How many times
I
can
do it
that?
As many times as I want, but I take 3 strain each time. Just so you know, I'm not flagrant here. Macron will look directly at Savannah and kind of looks a bit disapprovingly. And he says, "The reason you're here and the crowd has not turned against you is because we all have hope that people can be redeemed and make up for their past crimes, either through their people or through themselves, but done by their people or themselves. If there are in Pierce Hill, they should be given the same option almost all of us have, to choose a better life."
Ooh, like 4 setbacks.
Yeah, I guess I'm going to have to upgrade again.
Yeah, I'll upgrade back at you.
I have to make sure I don't have anything that can remove setbacks.
Tommy, are you using those as upgrades for yourself or for anyone?
Yeah, I'm going to use them for myself.
Okay.
Sadly, this uses vigilance and not something I could easily take setback off for. Not enough to make her fail.
Yeah, so the, you know, the crowd is very responsive to the evils of the Empire. A lot of them had suffered even before ever coming to Wayright. So you do negate two of what would be the damage. This is despair is that the crowd seems kind of resistant to your interjections at the moment. So what's going to happen there is effectively they're going to have soak against your attack, meaning that any more interjections are going to have two automatic failures. And take a strain from the threat. Okay, and I get one more turn, right?
Yep.
Okay. That's when Hakira stands up. You may not be an Imperial, but that kind of sympathy is not what we know around here. We live out here. We built this town from nothing. If there are Imperials here that want to destroy it, we're going to root them out, and we're going to do it ourselves. We don't need you. And so she is going to be trying a leadership check. Going to flip for her. Ooh. Okay. So the crowd seems to get riled up quite a bit by her words, but they're also like, we're self-sufficient. We don't need a leader, even from her. And so her leadership checks are going to have two additional failures from now on. But she's going to take some boosts from the advantage.
Do you guys mind if I go with our slot coming up?
I mean, you're probably the best person to go.
I would say...
More or less, you were Macron.
I'm sorry. It took me a while to remember I have this. Would you count despairs pointed at the crowd as despairs we could technically count pointed at us? I'm just wondering, because I do have an advocate talent here that lets me inflict strain on people who roll despairs or sufficient threats, but it has to be incoming towards us.
Yeah, so you can use that, but the other option is what I described with the leadership checks being less effective in the future.
All right, guy. I'll leave this up to the group. I can make her take 4 strain if we choose my option. But that's also making it harder for her to do anything to the crowd would also be something. So I'll leave it up.
I think in terms of doing strain to her, I don't think will be as advantageous in the way that this is set up compared to just making it harder for her to sway the crowd.
All right. Yeah, all right, then we'll go ahead and stick with your ID then.
All right.
Oh,
so
by the way, we can't actually see the name on Svenna there. Not that it matters too much, but so I'll let you know, Brandon.
Oh.
All right, so at this point, Ragesh is going to step forward and say, you may not realize this, but we have been ever vigilant in the threat of both the Empire and the Huts when it comes to Wayright. Some of you may have seen some footage of a Hut ball match, ritual combat between clans Jarama and Vermalik. That may not mean a lot to some of you, but some of you do know that Jarama is an Imperial allied clan. They are a clan of the Ancients. We cast them down, and their leader, Lel the Hut, is no more. They would have sold out information on Wayright if they could get their hands on it, and they were looking for it. This is totally a lie, but I'm trying to basically align the fact that we assassinated...
So that did get spread around, so you get 2 boosts from that.
Yay!
A setback from, once again, you know, you guys are wanting to do their job for them. Right. But I think you can take that away. But
Yeah. And then also at this point, Ragesh, or I'm going to say that as Ragesh steps forward, he's got some chew that is the Nerium root, but it looks more like just chewing tobacco. Just, you know, part of the whole ambiance of Wayright. But I'm going to take the two triumphs from my initiative roll as upgrades.
Is he chewing that while he's talking to them? Or?
Yeah. And like I said, it's kind of blending in with the whole local flavor. So two upgrades from that, an upgrade from the Nanarium root. So I will take two strain for that. And then I am also going to upgrade the check with a destiny. And what's the difficulty?
It's a set difficulty of two red and a purple for everyone.
Two red and a purple for everyone. Okay. I'm trying to remember if I can... No, that would be charm instead of deception, so never mind. Okay, here goes.
Nice. So yeah, that's more than enough to sort of put the crowd at ease. Tell me how they respond.
So I would say that some of them actually happen to be... Some of them happen to be former slaves of Clan Jarama. And so they've seen the collusion between the clan and the Empire. And so maybe they start talking like, oh, they helped with Clan Jarama. They're the worst of the Hutts. Absolute worst. Imperial collaborators, all of them. You know, these guys are okay. So spreading dissension through the crowd when they realize that we helped smash Jarama.
And I'm going to go ahead and put the blue bar as sort of a negative bar, just so we can fully push ourselves, just so your successes are fully counted.
Sweet, thank you.
Okay, the crowd is starting to realize, you know, maybe it's fine. Maybe these are the people that we need to handle this kind of threat.
Oh, by the way, the two advantages I will use as bad cop to throw two upgrades to the next check.
The next of their checks?
No, the next of our checks.
Oh, okay. Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm thinking of, because it's like, I have so many talents I'm trying to throw out here. I want to discredit, I'm not sure who, either the one pulling leadership, whose name I can't remember, or the arms dealer.
Harkira. The Harkira is a minor. She's sort of a, you met her at a cantina one time.
She's like one of the only ones without a token, I guess. Yeah.
Then I'll throw this on the arms dealer, because what I'm thinking probably makes a lot more sense for him. And that was two upgrades from the bad cop?
Yes.
Okay. Just got to make sure I have that, because it's another set difficulty one. Macron will point his accusatory finger at the arms dealer and says, "This man stands here to profit from your rage. He should not be considered an advisor to this debate, especially since whatever choice you make, he stands to profit from it. You should not listen to him. You should give him no heed."
Okay, and there's a set difficulty to that, right?
All right, yeah, it's a hard deception.
Yeah, I will upgrade it, and you see him glaring at you. Oh, there's almost a knowing glance from him, though. He knows who you are, Macron. Macron Duval.
Be better. All right.
Has he screwed us over at least once?
Attack onto that.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, what's that?
I need booster setback to attack onto this.
A boost for bringing up the fact that if there's going to be, like, a riot and people want to buy weapons, it would be from him.
Alright. I'm also going to flip to make the best use of all those upgrades I got from the bad cop. Alright. Not that bad. Okay, so any social checks he makes are upgraded twice until the end of the encounter.
Okay.
And I actually have one extra advantage left. You let me just pass a boost.
Yes, you can. Yeah, you can spend advantage for boosts and setbacks exactly like during normal combat.
All right.
And then someone had a setback, didn't they? I think it was
Lana.
No, I think it was her.
All right, hold on. You had secondhand loud go, and I'll made it fail. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's secondhand loud that has the setback.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay. Yeah.
We get everything in there. Sorry to have to use Packback's token, but it's there.
He's close enough.
Okay, I think there's one more of you that can go.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Dara will go. Who gave you a home, roof over your head, when the Imperials bombed your world? Who also helped you track down the murderer of your children?
What are you referencing there?
I am referencing... Oh, God, what was it?
It was
again?
The fire at the ranch house.
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, the fire at the ranch house.
So you're talking directly to the Zygerians then, not
yes.
to... Okay.
Yeah. And who else helped you when no one else will?
Oh, by the way, Deed, not to completely change what you're saying, but remember, we are also trying to sway the crowd, but there's a way that you can do both, because remember, the murderer tried to trick everyone and tried to frame everyone for this, and so it did affect everybody in the town, too.
Yeah, and you know, she'll try to bring up that, you know, we caught the person who committed these crimes and blamed everyone.
Yeah. Okay, a boost for reminding them of what you've done in the past, but three setbacks, because a lot of the people in this crowd were the people who started building Wayright themselves. So... saying that you helped build their homes, like, most of that doesn't apply to them. So, a boost and three setbacks.
Okay. And this is what, leadership?
Leadership or charm, it sounds like. So you can make the decision.
Okay. Oh, definitely charm. And I will flip.
Okay.
Just barely.
So it looks like that calms a few people. It looks like it mostly just some of the Zygerians that are still left on Wayright are nodding in agreement. They recognize what you've done for them. Okay. So we have Shulbar next, right?
Yeah, he'd be the last one.
Okay. So, Shulbar, I forgot to grab an upgrade from earlier, so I'm going to go ahead and apply it to him. Shulbar, like, gives a Wookiee roar to, like, make sure everyone is listening to him. And he shouts out, "The Empire has come, and we have to protect the children. We have to get to arms immediately." So... he is definitely going for coercion here. Spin that upgrade.
Could you maybe get a setback because the crowd seems to be leaning the other way at the moment?
Do you want to spend your advantages on that?
We don't need Garrus, but yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay, hold on. All right, I'm going to try and interject here.
That seems like an important time to do so.
Macron will pipe up and say, "Remember the last time you believed you were threatened by Imperials, and remember who came and protected you from them and their potential harm." And I'll just gesture around and point to all the mercenaries around him.
There's a loud roar back at you.
I don't have a pitch to roar back, but I wish Rebecca was here.
Yeah.
Rebecca would think differently.
We can flip a destiny and have Rebecca be right behind him. glaring at him menacingly.
And just so you know, he's using the triumph to add two additional successes to his check.
Okay.
I didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah, it's a smooth talker, right? So.
Okay.
Any booster setbacks I need to consider here? I do have the soak thing for the interjection.
Okay. No. I think we're good.
All right.
Was that for him or just for Harkira? I think it was.
Well, I thought the failures were just because the crowd's gotten sick of me just stepping over everyone's lines.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, exactly. So it was the despair on the previous interjection.
All right. Let me just double check to see if I've got everything set here. Okay, well, if nothing else, I can probably use those threat against him. But just to see.
Nice.
Wait. Oh, but Smithark wouldn't affect this because this is a vigilance check. All right, well, if nothing else, I'm going to suffer one more strain to have two of those threat he rolled turn into four strain. Macron's at least able to twist something back on Shulbar. Maybe he does stay, like Shurbeka would say differently. Kind of undercut him there.
And you, at the mention of Shurbeka, the mere mention of him, there's a low growl from Shulbar. You got under his fur. So is that two failures added to his, or how does that
work? No, that's not failure, that's just more strain on him. All this interjection has produced is given him less successes. He still succeeds.
Yeah, so you take two successes off of his check then, right?
Yes, and the other thing I was saying about Shurbeka is actually manifesting my twisted words talent to turn the threat he originally rolled into strain on him more so than it would.
Is that with the triumph, or...?
No, that's if I just take one more strain and he rolls a sufficient number of threats or despairs.
So what's your triumph doing?
I have no idea. Maybe pass an upgrade? Let's see here.
Could it kind of negate his triumph, maybe? Whatever that would have been?
No, that's not really recommended by the rules, usually.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think I have anything that would let me mechanically turn the triumph into anything, so I'll actually just use that to pass an upgrade.
Okay. I guess it's just me left and Bunker, but, you know. Bunker's not going to shoot the crowd, I'm sure. So...
Well, I mean, it's still a spot. It's still something that could happen.
It might tell them all we're part of the Rebel Alliance unless someone tells him to put subtlety mode on. Because he does not like the insinuation that he's an Imperial.
Go salty, Bunker. Go salty.
I guess, as a question to the GM and whoever else may know, is any of the town really aware at all that we're part of, that we're attached to the Rebellion in any capacity?
Some of them do, yeah.
Like any of the people here? What do you think?
The Wookiees, I'd say, would definitely be aware of that, just because Shurbeka has spent so much time doing rebellion jobs that, I mean, Shurbeka sort of provides a lot of the funds for the Wookiees, yeah. So it's like, where does this money coming from, Shurbeka? Otherwise, yeah, I don't know, and maybe you can, what do you think? What's...
I don't know. Either that, or I'm thinking maybe a different tack for Aiden, just because he's not quite as socially focused as, or anywhere near as socially focused as Regesh or Macron. But
yeah, maybe Aiden has been trying to recruit people every night.
Yeah, maybe Aiden's been in the crowd actually, and not actually up on stage. I'm thinking maybe he's streetwising his way through and just
You guys were stuck at the back because of when you came in, so no one's on stage other than Dox.
Oh, okay, it's just where they were on the thing. It looked kind of like they were front and center. Okay, so maybe Aiden's been kind of like worming his way through the crowd and kind of like trying to make his voice heard, but not necessarily be known that he's one of the mercenaries, per se. I don't know how many people would recognize him as such. I don't know if that's a thing that would make sense. What do you think?
So you're just kind of like trying to put whispers into the crowd sort of thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll allow that.
Okay.
Streetwise is definitely one of those like halfway social, halfway kind of not sort of abilities. So yeah, definitely.
Okay. And then same difficulty? The two red and the purple, or?
Yes.
I was going to say, that was a question.
All right, I was responding to D.
Okay. And there's a upgrade passed, right? From Macron?
Yes, it looks like it.
Okay, and I'm going to flip to gain more. Okay. Let's see how this goes. Well, no success, but maybe he adds
a mentor point at that.
Oh yeah, okay. Let's see.
Bah.
It's slightly more advantageous.
hold on, let's just a social check. I had a
look. It's streetwise, so maybe?
Yes, I'm saying it is.
Okay.
All right, well, if it's a social check, then I can interject to help.
I don't know if that really...
Yeah, that's kind of weird, because how are you interjecting when streetwise is like multiple little conversations here and there? You know what I mean? It's a little bit...
It could be a sweeping statement that sways whoever he was talking to.
Maybe.
Yeah, if you want to eat the strain, Macron's going to pass out just from this conversation. We're just in round one.
You'd be surprised how much strain I have even with there as a little kickback. Maybe I'll start taking advantages, though, to help with that. The creative juices aren't flowing this early in the morning, but Macron will pipe up and... What was the main theme of the conversations? I know you're trying to...
Aiden's just kind of walking around in the crowd, and like anyone who seems to be leaning towards our side of the conversation, he's kind of encouraging it. And anyone who maybe seems to be on the fence, he's kind of trying to, you know, he's throwing in little tidbits here and there of like, yeah, maybe we could do this, and that'd be good, you know, stuff like that. But he's not really like talking to the crowd at large. Like, he's going to individual people.
Then I guess the interjection would more be an alternate proposal.
That could work.
Maybe something along the lines of what he's been trying to get across to individuals.
Yeah, that can work.
All right. It is another interjection, so I'm adding the two failures. But, geez, you know what? I'm going to, as an incidental, flip to activate on match expertise to knock off two difficulty die.
Make this one really count.
Yeah. Well, it's going to count for the rest of the encounter, hopefully.
Yeah.
All right. I'm taking that advantage to take a strain back. I'll pack on two successes onto his check.
Okay.
Nice.
Okay, so that ends up reducing the fervor of the crowd a bit. And you can still spend Aiden's advantages like you do in combat. You can give a boost to the next person and then give a floating boost as well.
Yeah, I'll do that. So, you know, basically I'm planting the seeds of maybe not dissension, but of agreement.
Calm and
yes.
Friendliness.
And as an incidental, while it's still my turn, maybe I'll say to Bunker, maybe be a little subtle when you go. Maybe not outright state we're in the rebellion, but you can hint.
Subtlety mode.
Yes.
I mean, subtlety mode is just a mute button. Literally, when Aiden tells him to activate it, you just see a little speaker with an X through it show up on one of his little light things.
Look at the status lights.
You can still use an assist maneuver if you'd like, or however.
Yeah, that's what I was going to do. But how do we get here, by the way?
I assume there's a land speeder that you guys took, probably.
Yeah, from the base, probably, yeah.
Okay.
We rode in on Singe.
I don't know if Bunker would have any of his... Because he has the Alliance symbol printed on his heavy repeating blaster, but that's the thing, he doesn't take it anywhere where he's not, actually killing Imperials, so he probably wouldn't have it with him here. So he will just... shrug. I mean, as far as he is, he's just going to stand there and be confused that people are saying that he's an Imperial. He doesn't know why people are saying this. He doesn't
maybe,
like it.
Maybe his assist maneuver is, maybe he has the blaster, but it's not, being wielded right now, and maybe someone sees the Alliance symbol, someone who's sympathetic.
Well, if he had it here, within reach, he would have, gone, grabbed it, and just, held it up and pointed at the symbol. Just guys, it's kind of obvious, right?
Yeah. Well, maybe because Dox was so vague, Bunker thought relied on caution and went ahead and brought it. So.
All right. So Ego grabs it from the speeder and just holds it up by the receiver and just points at the rebellion symbol. And he'll just assist, I guess, Macron.
Okay, are we back at the top?
Yep.
Okay.
Can Dara give Washer a call?
It's not your turn.
Isn't it?
No.
No, it's the top. So we have, like, three NPCs first.
Oh, right. Sorry. Duh.
Okay. So secondhand Lao, you know, after being berated many times over, says, well, for all the protecting you think you've done of Wayright, we've still got Imperials here. So what have you done? What I mean, you really haven't helped anyone at all, have you?
I mean, I would think the whole crowd would just know that that's patently false.
He has two upgrades and a setback, so...
And if anyone else fails, I can always interject him again.
So, base difficulty is two reds and a purple. That goes to three reds and a purple and a setback. Okay. Ooh, oh man, that's...
That's an interesting
that's
call.
That's nasty. Yeah, he is going to burn the triumph to get three successes.
Oh.
Alright, hold
so
on.
So he ends up having two successes.
Jack's but... like, twist my arm, why don't you? I'll inject again.
But right now he has two automatic failures.
Okay, yeah, Macron will speak up. He's like, has anyone seen these Imperials? Has anyone have been harmed by these Imperials? If they have, then we would have seen that we always have. But until then... All we are ranting about what it appears to be simple fear mongering by an arms dealer.
That's a really good point.
So I'm actually going to do a bit of a twofer here. I'm taking the three strain for the interjection, but I'm also going to flip to activate intense presence actually get strain back. So what happens here is it actually goes down by one. So I have four ranks in four in presence. Case. Yeah, basically what Ugo says, Pixar didn't happen. It's not happening. So that gets rid of that. All right, I add two failures. Yeah. And actually, I'm also going to add two threat, too, to make sure he doesn't get nothing but the triumph. He already spent the triumph. He gets nothing.
He gets nothing.
Made him watch.
But two automatic failures on his additional check from the despair.
Sweet.
So yeah, the people, there's almost like a silence after he's spoken and you've spoken, and they're sort of like shaking their heads at him. They really don't understand what he's up to.
Like, why are you even here?
I will point out that the upgrades he has to his social check stick throughout the entire encounter.
Oh, okay, I didn't know that, actually. So let me go ahead and redo the...
The power of discrediting.
Yeah, he is not a credible figure here at the moment. So,
I mean, his name is literally Secondhand Lao. Like, you can't get a shadier name if you wanted to. Other than Sleaze Bagano.
So this coming in from Dibbler.
So, Hakira is, like, trying to redirect the conversation after that. She says, yes, you've been helpful. We know you're not with the Empire. We know you're good people. But we need to stand for ourselves. We need to take care of this problem. We can't come running to you. You might not always be here. We need to do this ourselves. So once again on the leadership side. Flip for her. Two reds and a purple.
Is the town also aware of our connection with Dox, other than, you know?
Yeah, I mean...
He brought us here, but...
Yeah, so the original reason you guys came in was Dox was leading like a little bit of a cult. And there was a big worm that you guys took down. Which there are actually still remnants of occasionally in the town.
Yeah.
Like built into structures and that sort of thing. Okay. Yeah, let me give her a boost for her next one. This does seem to be an undercurrent that they want to be self-sufficient. You know, they built this town. Some of them are still here from the original build. And then Shoalbear actually roars in agreement and says, "We should be the ones to kill the Imperials that are here." And so he's trying to bring up some bloodlust in the crowd as well. Flip for him. Oh, a little bit responsive. Not too much. Okay, that's my goes. You guys have,
I'd like to take the first slot only because Magrin has something he'd like to shoot back at Akira.
I'm not arguing that, but I'm just saying that just purely mechanically, though, Ragesh can use the bad cop to throw you two upgrades on your check if you wait.
Yeah, you know what? That's worth it. Yeah, you go ahead then.
Alright, so I need a second, though, to think, because actually Arcana kind of has a good point, but let's see.
Well, you know, just because they want to do this themselves doesn't mean they have to lynch random people that may or may not be stormtroopers.
Since we've already done this combo before, I think Mackin would see that Rogash is good at getting the crowd at least well enough to listen to perhaps more higher rhetoric. So he'll actually whisper in Ragesh's ear, "They may want to do this themselves without our help, but there is a chance we could perhaps teach them and lead by example."
Nice name drop, by the way.
Pay me money, FFG.
Right. Yeah, okay, so Ragesh will just say, "Listen, we totally understand where you're coming from. However, when it comes to your safety, that is our greatest concern, and we have been tireless in removing Imperial threats. There was actually, and I didn't want to bring this up, because I didn't want to spread fear throughout Wayright, but there was a concerted Imperial effort to find colonies that had not been registered. We made sure to wipe all records that were pointing to Wayright. They did not have Wayright's name, but shipments, this colony has been getting bigger. That has caused more scrutiny to come your way. And whether you wanted it or not, whether you knew or not, we have always been there to get rid of those threats." Lying through his teeth, but...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and at the mention of the town getting bigger, a more of an older man shouts, "You're the reason bringing in all these people!" And so there's going to be, going to be adding two setbacks to the check.
Okay. God forbid the town prospers.
I know, right? Luckily, I can get rid of those
setbacks. There is a bit of a racist undercurrent to what he said, too.
Ew, okay.
So. He says, brought in all these aliens! Taking our jobs!
I do have an extra upgrade, because I forgot to do an upgrade earlier, so I'm going to...
Build a wall and make the aliens pay for it.
Make the rebels pay for it.
Do I get any RP boost for that little tidbit?
One.
Alright. Okay, so... I will upgrade the check, and then I will take 2 strain from the Nanarium root. It lasts for 1 hour, 1 dose, but I have to take 2 strain every time I concentrate to use it. And I'm trying to think of anything else that... Alright, here goes.
It's what people do here. Oh.
I definitely am going to re-roll that one.
Yeah, that is very much deserving of a re-roll.
Alright, here it goes. Ah!
You know, it wasn't a double despair.
Actually, hold on. Let's see if I can't make that a bit better. I'm going to go ahead and interject here.
Max,
but why don't you help out
this whole conversation?
Alright, I'm tacking on the 2 failures. Macron will He'll buy into Rogesh's lie and tell them about how Imperial patrols the Outer Rim, strengthened by the day. Oh wow, that's fear mongering. and it's like, there must, if you are to stand strong against Imperial incursion, let us show you how to stand strong.
Good one.
All right. So any setback I need to account for? Boost, maybe?
Yeah, a setback and a boost.
All right. Luckily, because of an attribute, I actually get to take off the setback. I mean, not the magic expertise. Anyway, just have to make sure I don't do the failures. Okay, there we go. So yeah, I'll make sure his check succeeds.
Okay.
In fact, actually, since it helps out the cop, I'll change all of those three advantages to three advantages for him, making it five advantages total.
Oh, okay.
Cool. So yeah.
Successes end up being? Sorry. What is the actual successes on Ragesh's check now?
I'll change them all. So three.
Okay.
And then I'll pass two upgrades using two advantages, and that'll leave three left. So I'll also pass. Oh, I will do the next one and the floating. So two upgrades and two boosts to Macron. A little positive feedback loop there.
All right. Reciprocity. It's always a good thing.
Macron and Rogesh just going back and forth this whole conversation. Just talking to each other.
All right. Then Macron will take the next PC slot and pretty much just continue on the tangent he was going on. How Akira has a point. There may be a time where you need to take care of these problems yourselves, but while we are here, let us not do this for you, but show you how it can be done. And he doesn't say that in like a dismissive tone. He says that in more like a instructive tone. Like, let us show you how to make sure you don't just become a lynch mob strangling every passerby you don't know. He doesn't say that literally, but that's sort of what he's shooting for.
Yeah, we'll do the standard boost and a setback with that as well.
Alright, Kill with Kindness takes away the setback. Command gives me two boosts. And the standard difficulty is one purple, two red?
Two red, one purple.
Okay. Two I'll red, one purple. So the set difficulty is hard. And it gets turns to easy, upgraded twice to one red, so it ends up being two red. Okay. Let me just make sure I don't have anything else I can take off. Okay, nope, that's it.
Wow.
That's a lot of advantages.
Actually, you know what? I'm half tempted to take all of those advantages for strain recovery so I can go back into interjecting almost every one of these guys.
Do it.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah. That doesn't get a lot of sway at the crowd, but Macron himself feels a lot better.
So I'll take off an effort. Wow, that many. You took off that many and you still have that much strain? How much strain
Yeah,
do you
have? I have eight strains still.
What is your total?
My strain threshold is 21.
Okay. Aiden's not far off from that, actually. But,
I can just see Macron just be like, ooh, that sounded good.
Was anyone recording that?
You can
record our rockets, right?
Okay, so one more PC.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, Dara will take it, and she will call Washir and say, I'm sorry to bother you, but Shobar's in town throwing his weight around, pretending he's leader of your clan.
As usual.
As usual.
So, Washir, it takes actually a few moments before you actually get him on the comms. You know, there's a secretary, basically, who responds first. There's like a general, like, Wookiee compound number that you end up calling.
1-800-Wookiee!
Yeah.
Welcome to the Wookiee Talk Hotline!
Eventually, Washir comes on the line. You see him, you hear a bit of a soft growl from him before he responds and says, Sholbar has taken the security of the Wookiees in his own hands. If he is being overbearing, that is something we will discuss. However, I have given him my trust in this regard.
Okay. For your children's sake, I hope he doesn't kill any innocent people.
For the children's sake?
Yeah. You know, well, they say there's some Imperials around here and there's a lynch mob. Trying, trying to find out if there are any Imperials on this world. And she will remind Bashir of the time when Lieutenant Pelion was on planet.
And took some of them hostage?
Yeah. Obviously took some of them hostage, but we got the children back, and we just think that, you know, someone who is a lot calmer.
That might not be the best, because remember, we prevented them from taking their revenge that they really wanted on the guy.
Yeah. But... Well, I think someone who has a... someone who has an open mind would probably be better to talk to these people instead of your representative here.
So you would be aware enough to know that it would take probably... it would take a bit of time for him to come down there himself.
Could I do a reverse narrow escape?
Put him on speakerphone.
A reverse narrow escape?
Yeah.
Bring him here instead of...
Yeah.
So Weshir tells you that... he gives an invitation to discuss Sholbar's conduct. There's almost a layer of bureaucracy here that you're not entirely expecting, but you can tell that Wester has almost been trying to encourage Sholbar to take some responsibility. Maybe the idea of him actually being the defense of the Wookiees will make him grow up a bit. You don't think you're going to get him to just lecture Sholbar here in the moment.
Okay. Okay.
That form is essential, Jack.
Is it?
Right next to form.
But you do have a standing invitation to visit the Wookiees at the moment.
Okay.
So.
Okay, what she'll do is she'll hang up and see if she can record what's being said.
Okay.
And basically pipe it to them. Well, yeah, she's going to actually pipe it to the Wookiees, the Wookiee Enclave, so he can actually... Watch and listen to what's going on.
Okay. So that brings up NPC, which Svenna is the last one there. Let's see. From the horrors that the Empire has unleashed, we cannot take this possible incursion so lightly. We need to rally what we have here we need to keep ourselves safe. You see, there's a little bit of a tremble in her hands as she's speaking. You can imagine what the memories that she's recalling with the destruction of Zygeria, and you can tell definitely that her response is mostly out of fear. It seems like rational arguments aren't going to be too much to sway her. But she's going to continue to bring up the horrors of the Empire and try to convince the crowd otherwise. Let's see.
Can you perhaps get a setback for repeating the same point, basically?
Sure. Ooh. You see her shrink back after that argument. It doesn't look like a lot of people are really listening to her now.
And she died?
No, she's just lost the crowd.
Yeah.
The crowd suddenly got really angry, but then remembered they don't like Zygerians, and they turned on her.
Mm-hmm. So she seems to sit down. She seems to not have much energy for the arguments anymore and sits down.
Oh, Svenna. My sweet summer child.
Okay, we have Bunker and Aiden, and then back to the top. We'll see.
Thinking maybe Aiden can, continuing with the streetwise tack he was on before, could he maybe try to find out where these stormtroopers were sighted, like if these claims are actually even true? I don't know if it's something we can really do in a crowd like this, but...
No, you get the sense that you're gonna have to actually start the investigation to get that. You might be able to pick up some rumors in here, but that would be at the expense of trying to calm them.
Yeah. Well, I was just thinking maybe we could use that as ammunition. And be like, look, you know, we know they exist or whatever. We'll help find them maybe. But maybe I can just turn that into a charm. I don't know. I'm not really great at a lot of social checks, but
I guess it's got an interjection.
Yeah, so Aiden would try a charm and or something similar, and be like, "It's like, look, you know, if we, you know, assuming these claims are true and they're not just made up by someone like Secondhand Lao, you know, we can help look into these, and at the very least." Help you channel your drive to protect yourself into people that may actually deserve it, and make sure no one gets caught in the crossfire.
I like it. It brings back memories of whenever they started wanting to lynch different groups. The fact that the Zygerian house got burnt down. The fact that you know, people were blaming Evokide or blaming Wookiees. So two boosts on that.
Okay.
Would there be a boost if Dara could... I know it's not my turn, but, you know, Dara said that we could say, yeah, I actually helped pull the remains down and rebuild it.
Yeah, I think we can roll that into what's there already.
Sweet. Add another boost, or you mean that counts as one of the other two?
For the two boosts, yeah.
Okay. So that factors into that. Okay. Well, I think Jack needs destiny points for his interjection, right?
No, I don't. I just need to take three strain.
Okay.
That's why I was so desperate to gobble up what advantage I could get.
Fair enough.
Okay. Okay.
I like it so far. Let's see what Jack adds, if he does.
Oh, you've succeeded. I could perhaps mitigate the threat. Maybe. It depends on if I roll enough advantage.
If the threat would go as my strain, I'm perfectly okay with that, actually. Or whatever else you decided it was going to be.
So go ahead and just take three strain from that as you're just getting sort of exasperated dealing with these people. But that the last...
You second wind. I don't have that.
Jerk! Okay. You see the crowd really seems to sort of... No one's really, like, shouting anymore. They're really just sort of looking around, being like, Are we really going to go into lynch mobs again? Like, are we? Is that who we are? And so, does Bunker want to say anything to wrap up the round?
I mean, he's just still baffled at how anyone could possibly confuse him for a member of the Empire. I mean, he just is the Rebellion.
Do you want to say anything to that, or...?
The only thing he would say now is just demanding that people tell him where the stormtroopers are. So, that's all he'd want to say at this point. Okay. He just wants to go, you know, take care of the problem. He doesn't see all the point in all this arguing.
Mm-hmm. And with that, the crowd actually starts to disperse. That one success reduced whatever strain damage the others had put on them. So I actually had in my notes that if they're at zero at the end of round two, they start to disperse.
Cool.
Nice.
So the crowd calms, and you can see it breaking. Now you guys have to decide what you want to do.
I'm sorry, but is Hakira leaving with the crowd?
Yeah, you can see her. She remains by a little bit, probably talking to a few of her men. It sounds like they may be making their way back to the cantina that they're known for being at. Sholbar is sort of grunting. He's got a few of his Wookiee buddies. They sort of consider themselves the protectors of the Wookiees, and they seem to be leaving as well. Svenna is heading out as well. So there's enough time to catch any of them if you want to.
Well, as Hakira is leaving, Macron will approach her, and with a bit of a gentleman nod, he says, "You're right that something should be done, and you are right that the people of Wayright should learn how to handle things themselves. However, these decisions must be handled wisely, not... in the heat of passion."
You see her, she doesn't really say anything in response, but just sort of nods to you. She recognizes that you're a man of words more than she is, and she just, she starts heading out.
Maybe at this point, Aiden and Ragesh can go around asking about the, stormtroopers. You know,
yeah,
where they were seen.
Who actually saw, or who claimed to have seen.
Yeah, who saw them and where they saw them.
Yes.
And if they were in, like, full armor, or just people that sounded like they were stormtroopers, like, what's going on?
And so if there was a lynch mob going on, that would be an incredibly difficult thing to do. But otherwise, it's...
Good thing I didn't suggest doing that.
So otherwise, it's an average street check, a streetwise check to... ask around, see who actually reported in these sightings.
Alright, cool. And so I'm assuming that Aiden's giving me unskilled assistance then?
Yeah, I mean, it would be skilled if your role wasn't overall better than mine in every way. I can remove two setbacks, but, you know, whatever.
Okay. Yes, so Ragesh... is able to see that there have been two sightings. One was an elderly woman. Her name is Beldry Dudevane. And the other was a group of young men that were apparently camping. But as a part of the triumph, Ragesh... here's some rumors about these young guys, that they're kind of troublemakers. There's one woman that you end up talking to that sort of puts her hands on the ears of her younger child as she talks to you and says, and sort of mouths it more than anything, that they're into spice.
Well, yeah, that can complicate things. Does, with the advantage and triumph or whatever, do we know where they were seen? And
mostly in the forests.
Okay.
It seems like both Beldry was you know that Beldry's, well, she's actually a little bit outside of town. You can, from what you've heard, she's a very independent old woman, and so she seems to be closer to the forested area, and these young men were definitely camping in the forests.
So in the process of this, did we actually talk to these people or just heard about them?
You've only heard about them. You're going to have to go talk to them and decide which one you're going to talk to first, or if you want to split up.
I mean, normally so, I'm not up for splitting up, but I think that this case it would...
This calls for it, I think. Yeah.
I want to get Parker
wants to talk to the old lady.
Wait, what?
Parker wants to talk to the old lady.
All right, fair enough.
We're going to talk to the kids.
Aiden can go with the old lady then. We'll split up. Well, actually, Macron probably could. Really, it would probably work better.
Yeah, I mean, just
faces.
So let's do left for the young guys and right for the old lady.
So let's see.
Macron enjoys speaking with the elderly.
Yeah, that works.
Okay. Let's do Beldry first. So, Macron and his murder bot start walking to the...
He's more of a shield wall bot.
Exactly why I can.
Okay, so you start heading to the outside of town, you know, the trees start to get more populous. You know that if you keep going deeper, you're going to get to the Wookiee colony, but Beldry is a little bit closer into town. And so you find a nice, plain, wooden house. It looks like there's a little bit of a flower garden outside.
What are there, is it like a, kind of just a giant plot of arable soil with flowers growing, or is it any sort of design to it?
There, it's more of in actual, like, beds. More around the house than, like, a huge plot of land with flowers. Just, you know, here and there, something an old lady would actually be able to keep up herself, as opposed to needing people brought in. Otherwise, most of the land around her is not tilled, or it's not worked at all.
Interesting. So is there just, like, a crude... What sort of dwelling does she have as we approach?
It's just a basic wood cabin, one story. You might think of it as a, you know, it doesn't look like it has much in terms of square footage. It's pretty basic.
All right, I'll look at Bunker and tell him that it would probably be best if he stood probably 5 to 10 feet behind me as we enter, just so we can offer the olive branch without her immediately being intimidated by the massive war droid.
Bunker gives him a thumbs up. Carefully steps around all the flowers.
Alright, and with that, Macron will go up to the cabin and knock on the door.
Just a minute, I'll be there.
So you hear some rustling for a little bit, and through the door even, you can hear the creaking of the wood floors as she moves close to the door and then opens it. It doesn't look like there was any sort of lock on the door, by the way. She just opens it and says, "Oh, hello, I don't believe we've met."
Macron, and Macron will pull off a gentlemanly bow as he cranes his neck down.
Oh my, you're quite polite, aren't you? I am Beldry.
Yes, I believe word about town is that you have some knowledge about the possible Imperials on the planet.
Oh, you're an investigator then.
Yes, I would make sure these rumors are confirmed so that everyone can be kept safe.
I see. And it's just you then?
Oh no, and Macron will gesture behind him and say, this droid here is here to make sure I stay safe.
Oh, so you see her sort of squint a bit behind you. You're not exactly sure how far she can actually see, but she seems to recognize something behind you and says, oh, do come in, I'll make some tea.
Macron will quickly gauge to make sure Bunker can fit through the door.
Yeah, Bunker has knows his frame and is able to maneuver in without causing harm to the boat. You can definitely see that it is very rustic. You have one main room that is also the bedroom. You do have a sort of kitchen area where there's already... you can see a tea kettle behind a stove. It looks like a wood-burning stove. And she begins to fill it up with water and starts making tea as you guys sit down. Or however you want to handle that.
Macron will take a seat and kind of relax into it a bit. I see him put his force pike down on the floor next to him. And he'll say, have you actually seen the Imperials? And he'll probably prod that a bit inquisitively at her weakened eyesight.
Well, yes, I believe I saw one. It was at a distance, you see. But the uniform was very clear. You see, I was one of the first to come here at Wayright, and I was one of many who were escaping the horrors of the Empire. I won't forget those uniforms until the day I die.
And forgive me, when did you see them?
Oh, it was earlier in the week. So
Macron can tell that her sense of time is a little broken. As she tries to start to talk about the day, the actual day, but she seems to get confused on the days of the week and how they've passed. Before getting a little frustrated herself and just says, it was 3 days ago.
Tell me, how many times do you tend to your flowers each day?
Oh, I take great pride in my flowers. You see, Wayright here is the soil is very rich, and especially here near the forests, and I tend to them every day. They're my pride and joy.
Well, I'm forgive me, ma'am. I'm simply trying to get a good measurement of your time. I know being in the forest, the sun makes counting the time by the sun makes things difficult. Do you have a set schedule when you tend to your flowers?
No. I really have the same schedule every day. I wake up, I make sure all the house chores are done. I will usually walk into town around midday and go to my favorite restaurant, one of the first that were actually here. It was started by my friend, but she's since passed away. Her husband was a miner, one of the first to discover the ores here, you know.
Oh, is she still working at the mines, or has she retired elsewhere?
No, they've both passed away.
Oh, my condolences.
But the store is still being run by her grandchildren.
So, back to the pertinent matter. When you saw the Imperials, did you hear anything, what they were doing, what they perhaps might have been saying?
So she begins to describe the scene. She really focuses a lot in on the uniform. And then she mentions the actual rank that she saw. She describes it. She isn't able to actually tell you what it is. But you know from what she's describing, it's a lieutenant's rank. And she also mentions hair color that you recognize as Pelion's hair color. It's really starting to come together a little firmer in your mind.
Macron leans back in his chair, but aghast at that revelation. And he looks over at Bunker.
Bunker's just looking between Macron and the old lady, like he's waiting for someone to drop something, like drop some kind of intel. Like he's ready to go. So he's just like, give me the coordinates. What am I waiting for here?
He's about to ask you, do you have the latest status update on where you believe on where Lieutenant Pelion should be?
Bunker just shrugs. He doesn't get that kind of stuff.
It'd be definitely something that you'd be able to look up, though, at some point.
All right. Macron will nod as he and this officer was alone.
Oh yeah, it's from what I could see, he was just walking in the forest. You know, it was such a shock to see it. I froze in place until it was gone. You know, the forest can get a little misty too, and so he wasn't too far before he could walk out of my sight. I scrambled back into town as soon as I could overcome my fear.
Could you tell if he was walking anywhere specific? Towards town? Towards the Wookiee enclave?
Huh. Well, he was going deeper into the forest. I guess that would be the Wookiees. You know, they're actually really great neighbors. I was worried when they first came in here, but they even help me with the flowers every so often.
Yes, I believe they're the greatest example of the galaxy's kindest giants. Macron tosses that compliment as he thinks of Shorbecca.
I do have to sweep whenever they visit, though. That fur, it gets everywhere.
Yes. Macron will stand up and reholster his weapon behind his back as he says, "Ma'am, if I could be so bold, would you have you considered getting any sort of assistance around here? Perhaps maybe another droid? A droid?"
She sort of waves her hand at that and says, "I've been on Wayright too long, young man. I can take care of myself. We started this town out of nothing, and that's the way we do things here."
Macron smiles as he nods and says, of course. And he'll bid her pardon as he and Bunker leave.
Okay.
And as they leave, Macron will turn to Bunker and say, "There's information on Lieutenant Pelion I believe we might want to double-check, but we could follow the route more directly and perhaps visit the Wookiee Enclave next. What do you think?"
Bunker shrugs. He's sulking a bit because he realizes that he's probably not going to get to shoot anyone today. And he kind of gives a reluctant thumbs up.
Macron will look towards the Wookiee Enclave and say, "Well, given the glance Shobar was shooting at me during the meeting, you may have a chance to punch something." And with that, they'll head towards the Wookiee Enclave.
Okay. So while the connection is kind of intermittent here, you are able to at least access the broker's network, just to get to the files. As far as you're aware, Lieutenant Pelion is on Jagamyr. There's no indication that he has left Jagamyr.
Just to make sure, I mean, you guys get the implication of what's going on, right?
I as a player do. Macron doesn't, because he has very limited interaction.
We would also assume that we would be in contact with each other, though, right?
Yeah, but this is happening at the same time.
Oh, right. Never mind.
So they have, you know, it actually took them a little bit to march out to her house.
Right.
So
that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I guess with that confirmed, that then they are going to go into the Wookiee Enclave, so that seemed to be his next stop.
Okay. So, let's go back to Ragesh, Aiden, and Dara. And so you ask around a bit around where these young men live, and you sort of get not too far from the center of town, but it looks like there's just an upper apartment above a sort of shop, and you're told that there's a group of guys that live there.
All right, well, you know, might as well be nice at least at first, so just knock on the door.
Yeah, normally. Just keep your holsters unlatched, just in case.
Dara doesn't have holsters, she's got all her stuff's magnetic.
Ooh, nice. Yeah, so you just approach and knock on the door, or what do you do?
Let's see. Well, maybe we could have one person kind of be at the back, just in case any of them want to run. Because, I mean, they're kids and they're stupid, so...
Aiden can hang out.
I was going to say, Dara would take the back.
Well, Aiden could also do some... he can stay hidden, so they don't even know he's there. I don't know what Dara's stealth would be.
Two green, two yellow.
Yeah, well, Aiden's is four green, or five green, so... Or, no, actually, no, six. Yeah. Six green. So, you know, whatever you want to do.
Doesn't matter to me.
I guess Aiden will hang back then. He'll kind of like...
Okay, if you want to take the back, Dara will go in with Ragesh.
Yeah, Aiden will hang back, you know, behind the door frame, like listening and watching as best he can while staying hidden.
Okay.
You want to roll stealth or...
No.
Okay.
Okay. So Ragesh Knox.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. As Ragesh Knox, you can hear that there were voices behind the door, like three guys probably, from what you can tell. And then as you knock, there's just a silence for a minute, for a few moments, sorry. And then there's some scrambling. There's, like, people trying to shuffle things around. And, like, one of them screams out, yeah, just a second, just a second. You can hear the sound of, like, spray bottles going off.
Yeah.
And then someone approaches the door and sort of moves a slider, and so you can see their eyes and says, what's up?
So I just say, look... I'm not here about the spice. I'm an addict myself. Don't even worry about that. We've just heard some stuff about possible Imperials, and we're just trying to help out the town. And if we could just ask a few questions about the sighting, that's all we're here for. So I'm actually trying to use a charm check.
Okay. Yeah, so let's make that... I'll flip. It's going to be three red and two setbacks. What is Ragesh wearing?
Just as normal, like, trying to look like just a regular Wayrider type of clothes.
Okay. Yeah, so two setbacks on that.
Alrighty. Let's see, I need to double check with setbacks, because I don't usually use charm, so... Alright, I can remove one. Alright, and... I will take some strain. I wipe two strain between encounters, so I'll just not move the bar, but I am using congenial, so I'll downgrade one of those. I will upgrade the check, and you know, actually, just for RP reasons, I'm gonna say that no, I shouldn't do that for this, never mind. Okay.
You sure you're not with a marshal?
I mean, we've talked, but no. like I said, you know, I'm into that, and I kind of do a little sniff and myself.
Okay.
Did I get the difficulty right? Sorry.
Yeah, two red and a purple. Okay. Yeah. Right. Yeah. Okay. So the guy's like, you hear the thing slam shut, and there's like some whispering. You can hear that there's a little bit of an argument between them before they're like, if there's Imperials, like, then we can't do this at all. Like, what? I mean, if they're trying to find the Imperials, I mean, come on! And they're just sort of arguing back and forth for a little bit before it seems like one of them actually has the nerve and then just opens the door and says, okay, dude, we're gonna... Let's talk. And so you see the other two, they're... I mean, the three of them are pretty frazzled looking. They may not have showered recently. It's a little bit of a mess of a place. You kind of wonder about, like, bugs and stuff in the area. It's a little gross, but, you know, there's some, like, half-eaten pizza in a box, and it's not, like, completely disgusting, but still one of those, like, come on, guys.
Yeah.
Let's clean this place up.
Actually, I'm wondering, with Ragesh's one-night stint as, and I'm trying to remember, Ben.
Oh, yeah, what was the name?
What was the name of that Ivakai hero?
Oh, the Night Watchman.
The Night Watchman. Yes. So, yeah, Ragesh's knight is the Night Watchman. Do any of these kids look familiar?
Yeah, you might have noticed one of them just, like, on a corner. You would know what he was trying to do. He was probably selling. But, you know, it wasn't enough to justify busting him.
Right.
So you probably noticed him, but realized there are bigger things to worry about.
So, has the Night Watchman been as active, or has Caster kind of quieted down on that front?
It's a question, Ben.
I mean, he's probably up for a while because of his injuries, but... I don't know.
Encourage him while we were there, right? I'm pretty sure we did.
I don't know how long it would have taken him to recover, but I guess once he was done, he would have gone back into it at least a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Based on the streetwise that you had earlier, that you know that the Night Watchman's still around.
Okay. So, I guess what I'll say is, I'll hold that information for now, but I'll sit down in the one clean spot that I can find.
Is Dara following in?
Yes, she is.
Okay. It's like, you got an entire company coming in?
If a company's two people.
I mean, you could have said, I don't know.
Do you need glasses? She was right behind me.
Dude, I mean, whatever.
And I take it she's very... at this moment, is she really, really distracting due to what she's wearing?
They're pretty mellow guys, but, you know, they're younger men, so sure, they're looking at you.
So, listen, like I said, I indulge in some of the good stuff, too. Imperials are not so great for things like that, because when Imperials are around, people lock things down. So I'd like to take care of this as soon as possible, and I'd like to get some information on what you actually saw. So let's talk about that.
Yeah, fine.
So when did you see Imperials? What? How did you know they were Imperials?
I mean, like, you know Imperials, man, right? Like, they were stormtroopers. Like, the white uniforms and the guns. Like, it's obvious.
And where did you see them?
I mean, we were camping in the forest. And, like, we were smoking a bit. And, I mean, it's you know, it's fine out there. And there's no one bothering. The Wookiees... They stay back, and, you know...
So, you know, were there... Oh, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Oh, So, were there any mushrooms involved with this little camping excursion?
Mushrooms? Like, that's... Like, you have to find, like, seeds for that, bro. Or whatever mushrooms come from.
So, whatever... come on, let's just cut to the chase here. What were you guys on when you were out there?
So, I mean, it would be, basically the, like, death sticks, probably.
Okay. So, nothing... I mean, I would know that that's not,
It's not hallucinatory, no.
Okay. How many... Dara... Oh, go ahead.
Dara will, thumb through, some of her photos in her, Chiss uniform, and she will say, well, they were dressed like this.
Are you showing them a picture of a stormtrooper?
No, picture of her in her white dress uniform.
No, they weren't blue, they were all white. Like what? Like, we know a stormtrooper. A stormtrooper is a stormtrooper. There
right,
were three
so
of them.
What did the stormtroopers do when you saw them? Because they probably saw you, if you had a campfire.
Yeah, they like coming over, and they like their blasters were pointed at us, and we just started running, man. Like, what would you do?
All right. Well, I mean, I guess I want to do a discipline check to see if these guys are lying or not.
Dara will then ask, "How many?"
There were, I guess three.
And how many of you are here in this room?
I mean, we're three. I mean, can't you see us?
Sorry, I thought you may have had a few more out the back.
I don't know what you're insinuating.
I just thought.
I don't know what she's insinuating either. So
yeah.
I thought there was slightly more of you here, apart from you three.
Can I do the get a discipline check though on the
Yes, let's make that two red and a purple. Or do you want me to roll it actively?
Yeah, you can roll actively, but I'm going to say that I'm going to use clever solution because I'm just Ragesh is really looking at these kids and he's thinking about the drug use, and so for this role, it'll be his discipline, but it'll be based off of his cunning. So it'll be two reds and three purples. And
three purples. Okay. Yeah. From what you can tell, that's what they experienced.
Okay.
One thing that makes you kind of curious, though, is that. You didn't say the stormtroopers fired at them.
Right. Alright, so...
Yeah, how long ago was Laws of War in-universe? I mean, that was...
Oh, I mean, real time was really matched at the same time, so yeah. It was... You know, back in...
Yeah.
I forget which holiday it was, though.
It was over a year ago, because remember it was... We ran... Letters home on the anniversary of that, right?
Right, okay. Yeah, yeah. It's been a while.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, they describe where they were camping out. You know that it's towards the edge of Wookiee territory as well. Mm-hmm.
Mysterious, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so I'll say... I'll just say thanks for the info, and... Gosh. Anything else you want to add there?
Not if...
Did they say what the stormtroopers wanted from them?
Yeah. Did they say anything to you?
What? No, we weren't hanging around. They actually didn't say anything at all. There wasn't any sound from them, actually.
Yeah, Ragesh has got an idea percolating in his head about this, but...
Yeah.
Alright, well, thanks for your time, and Yeah, he's not even going to try to give any adult advice. These kids are hopeless, so he'll just leave them be.
Regesh has already written them off.
Yeah. Yeah, the youth just say, right? Yeah, she'll say, thank you very much for your time, gentlemen.
Yeah, whatever.
So, after they walk out of the building, I guess, Aiden will just listen in real quick to see if they'd say anything, like, immediately after they leave. But
I do.
You can see them, like, why did you let them in? Like, this is our place. And they're just, like, screaming at each other, mostly.
Okay, nothing useful, then.
No, okay. Nothing useful at all.
Sounds like a common theme with those things. Okay.
So once we get a little bit away, I'll contact the other team and start sharing info.
Yeah, and you realize that both of you seem to be pointed towards the Wookiees at the moment.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay.
So, Daryl will say, well, we've got an open invitation from the clan leader.
Yep.
We'll just head that direction then.
Okay.
Hop a speeder or something.
And I'm going to ask, has the Morphoid ever been known to... is it limited by mass in terms of... Can it impersonate multiple people at the same time?
You have never seen it transform into more than one thing.
Okay.
Wait, what is this?
It's this
I
thing
feel like
that,
I missed something.
Yeah, it's from one of Jack's adventures. It's well, I'll let Jack explain it.
It is a creature made up of both sort of like a mix between nanomachines and biological cells, and it is basically a giant mass of basically a shape-shifting mass. Have you ever seen Deep Space Nine?
I have not.
Okay, well, that doesn't help me at all.
But your original description kind of gives me a...
It's basically a kind of a liquid creature that can take any form or shape.
It's like a Terminator.
Yeah.
I never saw the Terminator movie, so... Oh.
So our references have reached an impasse.
They have.
So, yeah, Regesh will mention... And, I mean, I'm just saying what we as players may probably already be thinking, but, you know, something's going on with what happened here with Lieutenant Pelion and his stormtroopers and... don't know. I mean, something weird is going on, but I don't think that we're dealing with actual Imperials here. Something is calling on the past. And with all the weird stuff that we've seen with our Force sensitives in the group, that Regesh is just like, yeah, okay, par for the course. Let's figure out what this weird.
He's not weirded out by any of this anymore.
Right. I mean, before it would just be like, oh, what's going on?
Aiden's kind of the same way. He's a little blasé about it now.
Okay, so you guys are able to meet up along the way, and you go up the colony seems to be expanding more and more every time you see it. And so I assume Dara gave Weshir a call saying that you were accepting the invitation. And so you're actually met at the edge of territory by Shorbecca and Sholbar, both of them together, and they lead you further in. And you've got an invitation to the main path. So you are in the tree fort, basically, with Weshir and just a group of Wookiees. It looks like this is probably the Wookiee council, as it were.
Greetings.
Greetings. Weshir talks. You see a friendly growl from Shorbecca, but you just see Sholbar kind of rumpf. So I believe you had some concerns.
Yes, there have been some sightings of Imperials, and Regesh will just be like, but you know, don't you know. Don't jump to any conclusions. We actually think something else is going on. Things are matching way too closely to when Lieutenant Pelion and his stormtroopers were here. Is there, have you noticed anything strange? Unrelated to stormtroopers, or related, anything strange recently?
What would you consider strange?
Things that appear that shouldn't be there, voices that you can hear where there's no source, anything of the like.
Is anything out of the ordinary for here?
I'm not sure what you're suggesting.
Well, actually, Sanguine Rhino, he is force sensitive, right?
I don't think so.
I don't think he is.
I'm mixing him up with the raccoon, so never mind. Do we know of any Force-sensitive Wookiees?
No, you really don't.
I imagine they're pretty rare.
Can I get a perception check? 3 red from everyone.
Sure thing.
All of us individually?
Yes, individually.
What about vigilance?
Oh, I'm sorry, you said 3.
Vigilance is fine, too.
Okay. I'm gonna flip for that.
Oh, man.
She's always
oh, my God!
Wow!
Nice! Aiden has no idea. Whatever's happening is just me missing entirely.
Okay, not sure what to do with all these despairs, though. This is kind of crazy.
That's insane.
Shobal decides now's a good time to pick a fight.
So who actually succeeded? It was Macron and Dara.
Dara, yes.
Both Macron and Dara, while the conversation is going on, you notice a stowaway. It looks like in a tree nearby, sort of trying to stay hidden, is one of the Wookiee children. One of them you recognize, actually. It's Limowick. You see him, like, trying to spy on the meeting.
Dara will head that direction.
Well, he's in a tree.
Macron isn't going to move, but he is going to specifically look at Limowick and just wave. Quite publicly.
Okay, there's a little shriek from him as he's realized that he's been found out. And sort of all the Wookiees look over at him and are kind of confused as to why he's there. So Shobar is his father, right?
Yes.
Okay, Shobar starts growling very angry at Limowick for, you know, this is a council meeting. You're no children allowed. And you hear just Limowick sort of kind of whining.
Dara will say, don't be too mad at him. He's only interested in what his dad does.
Yeah, okay. as you speak up for him, he sort of, you hear, you know, just a soft little growl, and he says, I've seen weird things. And all the Wookiees sort of just look at him, like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, Dara will continue his way, because, obviously, hands where he can see them, and says, do you want to come down and talk to us, or talk to me? And she'll sit down and pat the ground next to her.
So Limowick sort of looks to his father, like, if he has, like, permission to actually come into the meeting. And you see Strawbear starts to growl and says, this is no place for children. We can't talk about them.
Well, if he has supposedly seen them, or seen things, which is really weird, then perhaps he might be able to help.
Sort of growl at that. And you see Weshir, saying, Shobar, this may be what the visitors need. And so he, Weshir invites Limowick as well. And so he comes down sort of nervously looking to each of you.
Alright, so tell us what you saw, or what you've seen.
Well, I'm not supposed to.
Why not?
It's gonna get them in trouble.
Get who into trouble?
And Aiden will actually... Go ahead.
No, go ahead. It's fine.
Aiden will actually pipe up as well. It's like, they're already in trouble. If they're not deserving of the trouble, this can get them out of it.
Actually, Ragesh will, kneel down in front of Lumawick, and as convincingly as possible, will just say, don't worry. Nothing's going to happen to anybody, no matter what you say. Like, it'll all be fine. I'm trying to use deception. I mean, Ragesh is going to come down hard on anybody who's been doing stuff, but, yeah.
Yeah, so this is a Wookiee kid, so I'm going to say Wookiees have one willpower, so it's an easy deception.
Sweet. All right. I mean, Sir Gush here, do we even need to roll?
I will upgrade just for the chance at another despair.
I'm going to upgrade as well, just in case, because you never know. I could roll all blank, so...
I think he got it.
Yeah, so you see Limowick sort of kick the ground a bit and say, we just wanted it to be a joke. It was, it's
you
Thomas.
You dressed up as stormtroopers, really?
No, we didn't. How could we do that? That doesn't make any sense.
Well, you'd definitely be a little too short for stormtroopers.
Well, you know how Morphe can transform into people?
Yeah.
Well, do you remember Thomas? And you recall that Thomas was the youngest of the Wookiee children that you rescued from the slave camps. Mm-hmm. You always thought it was kind of unusual because he wanted to be referred to as Thomas. He didn't want a Wookiee name.
Oh, okay.
And so that was that he that was the even after he was rescued, he still wanted to be referred to as Thomas. And he says, "Well, Thomas, he can make things."
Ah, okay. Don't worry.
and they're afraid they're afraid they're gonna get in trouble, so they ran away.
Where to?
Okay, after he says that, there's a large grumble from the Wookiees, who said, everyone's like, where, okay, so there's a grumble that says, like, okay, the children, where are the children right now? And there are some calls back that says, actually, does seem to be a group of them that are missing at the moment.
There's a group of
How many of them are missing?
About four. And Limowick sort of is kicking the ground and says they went to the cavern. They didn't want to be get in trouble.
Oh, this bodes well. It's like, oh, don't worry, they won't be in trouble. And thank you for being a snitch. Snitch is a good word, Lumawick.
Yes.
We promise we won't tell them if you told us.
Yeah, we figured this all out on our own. But okay, so where's this cave? We need to get there now.
Yep. And the Wookiees are wanting to send like everyone with you as well.
I actually say, hold up, just. I know that these are your children, but just think about how scared it will be because they will think that they're in serious trouble seeing all of you.
I mean, they are, but...
Yeah, maybe just one or two. And I'll even say, I don't know, Shulbar can be so grumpy. I'll just say, maybe just one or two of you come with us, but not everyone.
One or two of their parents, maybe.
Trebek and Washir. There. Put that there. One we can count on for being a friend, the other one seems to be a nice, wise leader.
Mm.
Yeah.
And then Shulbar says, no, the Weshir must stay here. I'm going to be the one that goes.
Don't you want to have reign over the village while he's gone?
This is your chance to seize power.
So he sort of. Do you say that?
No, he's not going to say that directly, but he says, no, the Wookiees need a strong leader.
To defend in case.
No, he'll say the children will need someone to calm them, the village needs someone strong to protect them while Bashir's away.
It's not bad.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Bashir doesn't need to be away, though. If I go.
Alternatively, Shobar, we can send one of their parents.
What is the first thing you're going to do when you see these children in any sort of strange predicament? You're going to... You know what? No. Macklin will kind of take a bit of the high road to his haughty attitude and say, you're going to rush in there and your attitude will probably scare the children into doing something stupid. We need someone who will come in there and reassure them that things are all right and that they're fine. Your attitude at the Wayright meeting makes me believe that you will probably make things worse, not better. And I don't care if he's going to get pissed at that, because he most likely is. I'm just calling it like I see it.
He's kind of already pissed anyway. It's like his perpetual state of being.
No, specifically at me.
Yeah, so let's roll charm here. 2 red and a purple as well. I'll go ahead and flip to make that 3 red.
Okay, let's see here. Charm. Gotta make sure I have nothing that will downgrade it. Actually, no, it's looking like I don't have it.
What, you don't have anything in charm?
No, there's nothing I can use to, like, down... I have 4 yellows I can throw at this, but it's a bit of a tie. I was hoping I could get rid of some of the red. I guess just to tack on another die, I'll flip. Oh, and you flip too, so I guess is it 3 red and purple now, or is it still 2
it's,
red?
It's just 3 red.
Okay.
I can do skilled assistance with you and downgrade one of them.
Did you flip twice there, Jack?
I clicked once. Is it? I'm seeing 3 light, 5 dark, which I think it should be.
That's... And the number of them is fine. I'm just looking at the...
Yeah, I know. I noticed that too, but that's what happened with the force roll. Skill assistance, what are you giving me, like, 5 ranks in presence?
No, actually, I won't change anything except for downgrading one of the reds. We're both at 4 yellow, but we can still do skilled assistance, so I can leverage talents with you.
We can? Mm-hmm. Huh, didn't know that. Alright, so how much does that downgrade?
Just 1.
Okay. So that's the same...
So, as Shobar begins to get a little indignant, Weshir puts a hand on his shoulder and says, I agree with you, Shobar. I don't think I should be the one to go, but you are the captain of the defenses of the city. You should remain as well. Shorbeka and Liakmapo will go.
That works.
Okay. So you guys set out, headed towards this cavern area. It's known to the Wookiees. They've really not scouted much there, but they know it's there. And as you guys are approaching, there is a loud, like, Wookiee children cry, and you see 3 young children racing towards you.
All right, I race towards them. What's wrong? What's going on?
in the cavern, there are worms.
Oh, great.
Thomas stayed behind. He did the thing.
He did the thing? Alright, Aiden's gonna...
Bunker's already running into the
unholster his blasters, and he's following. He's actually probably ahead of Bunker, because he's pretty fast.
Yeah, so Liakmapo and Rebecca are going to stay back with the children that are running, and you guys go running into the cavern.
Ragesh is going to jam himself with the stem, too, as he's going.
I'm going to take advantage of this brief interlude to also flip for cunning, the cunning reduction. Get some more strain back. I think it's contingency plan.
Nice. Well, that didn't work.
Yeah.
Here we go, so.
It makes sense. If he's running and just like, oops.
Okay. So you guys, the Wookiee children, run past. Shorbeka and Liak Mampa are going to stay behind. You guys run forward into the cavern.
And this is very zoomed in.
Yes, so make sure you can position it. What you see are, for those of you that remember the siege worm that attacked the actual town, these look like just, you know, very young versions of that thing. But you also see Thomas very, very close to them, dangerously close to them. He seems to be holding out his hands, and beyond that, you see sort of, not necessarily holograms, but you see the light shifted around in the form of a group of stormtroopers. These worms seem to be distracted by that and are trying to munch on the stormtroopers, but there's nothing obviously there.
So, potentially an illusion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, let's roll initiative. And Aiden, because Aiden can run faster, he is a range band closer.
He doesn't have to be, honestly. He's good at long. Where was everyone else at, I guess?
So everyone's going to start long.
Aiden would actually like to stay at long, so okay. That's fine.
So you hear Thomas whining as you guys are approaching. It doesn't look like he's going to be able to keep this up much longer.
If you guys let me go first, I can try to use my jump boots to get over to him.
Yeah, go for it. Please save me a destiny point, though.
Yeah.
Yes, Macron, you can't interject the worms. You can probably interpose, as in that might not go so well for you.
I met your father. He was a wimp.
Your father smelt of elderberries.
Okay, we've all rolled, right? Okay.
Your father's entrails are being examined by a troll.
Oh no!
Is that still happening by now? I mean, it's been months. Years, potentially.
Oh, no. Like, I think one of the gifts Dox gave him was, like, a baby version of that, but I was specifically told it would never grow that big.
Mm.
But, yeah, that's out there somewhere. Doing science-y things. For the good of all of us.
That's a good initiative.
Yep, and Dara's doing rapid reaction as well.
Yeah, remember that whenever you actually roll, you can add an automatic success to the roll as you're doing it, so.
Yeah, I never do it for things that are, like, conditional on getting something first, though, because then I might consider that, you know, as part of the initial result. But.
All right, so
I don't know what that is.
If you guys are okay with it, I'll try to do the rocket jump.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, I'll use one maneuver to try to do two maneuvers. So long to medium for the first one. And how hard are you going to make that?
What's the jump you're doing? Sorry.
Well, I would like to get to him. What I'm trying to do is two consecutive maneuvers worth to go for range bands. So.
I guess quick question, okay. Actually. Well, are we long from Thomas or long from the worms?
They're kind of grouped up together.
Oh, so they're all effectively the same range band?
Yes.
Yeah, so okay. I'm doing one maneuver to try to jump to medium and then the next one to get engaged
with
Thomas.
Yeah, so it would just be average for both.
Awesome. Okay, here's the first one. And I am going to flip because I really need to get close to this kid to protect him. All right, so first one, what do you want to do with that threat?
Strain.
And then here's the second one. Phew.
Yeah, you can spend that advantage to recover strain if you want to.
Yeah, actually, I will do that. And then, so is he short distance from these things?
Yeah.
Okay. I will then... let me think about this, though, because I want to make sure that this kid doesn't get hurt, so... Yeah, I will use an action to... I'll just attack them. I'll since they're busy with the stormtroopers, so... Alrighty. I can't aim. I will use frenzied attack, though. Make sure to take that strain. What are their defenses?
Adversary 1 and defense 2.
Adversary 1, defense 2. Alright, here goes. Yes!
Nice!
Alright, so I am going to stagger the one at the top.
Okay, so how do you actually go about doing that? Its hide is you know, obviously it's not as mature as its possible parent, but it's you know that the damage you did not get through, but what do you do to actually stagger it?
Oh, yeah, so Ragesh, you see him whip forth, it swings around, and even though this thing is pretty big, Ragesh is cybernetic, and he's actually going to pull the whip hard enough to slam its head into the ground.
Oh, okay.
If that doesn't stagger, I don't know what will.
Okay, yeah, oh, that's not where I need to be. Oop. Okay.
And so, I tell Thomas, stay behind me.
He gives you a sort of affirmative little roar, and then you see him sort of stagger a bit himself, and he actually falls down unconscious.
Oh boy, okay.
And the illusion fades.
Well, he can't run, that's for sure.
Right.
So, Aiden would like to take the next PC slot, if you don't mind.
Before you do anything, I'm thinking...
Okay.
I'm going to have Macron do Inspiring Rhyme just to make sure I can't pass around some boost for everyone. At least everyone that's still by him. Just so we can all do a bit better, especially since we have a bit of a problem with a lot of our shooters. We're going to have to deal with people in the line of fire. So, he's just going to say... he's going to go on a limb here and say, Thomas is someone we can't allow be harmed. He's special.
That definitely seems to be the case.
All right. So, okay, I can hit everyone that's still in short range of me, so...
Aiden would be definitely, and Dara.
Yeah.
Bunker
so,
is questionable.
Aiden and Bunker maybe don't get strain recovery, but you do get a boost for 4 rounds. And,
nice.
Dara, you go ahead and take 3 strain back, and you'll also get a boost. Oh, wait, can you hit yourself with Inspiring Rhetoric? I forgot.
I don't have that.
Yeah.
On any of my...
That's a good question. Another instance of Mac going, ooh, I like the sound of that.
I guess I'll leave it up to you, Brandon. Do you think Mac to be inspired by his own rhetoric?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
He believes it, right? So.
I believe in me.
Don't believe in yourself. Believe in the me that believes in you.
I was just about to throw out that freaking line, man.
Don't forget, I believe in miracles and a thing called love.
Is he doing anything else this turn?
Actually, yeah, he'll spend 2 maneuvers to get into... Whoops, didn't mean to pull that up. Get into medium.
Okay, so Aiden, while still back at long, will pull out his blaster, his other blaster, because he already had the one out, with quick draw. And then he will activate unmatched mobility. Actually, maybe he will move in. Never mind. So maybe he was back there before, but he'll move in now, I guess. I don't know. I'll just use it for the free maneuver. So I'll get 2 aims onto the bottom tunnel worm, and he's going to use both of his blasters. What are their defenses again?
Adversary 1, defense 2.
Okay. Man, that's closer than I thought it would be. I probably don't do enough damage to get through their soak. Because that would be 6 damage pierce 2, but... Or 7 damage pierce 2, rather.
Nope.
Hmm. So... I don't think he can really do much else with that, but he does technically hit with both of them. So he does have 3 advantages to spend. I think he's going to have to move in, honestly. He has a maneuver left, so he's going to move in half a range band, because that's all he can do with one maneuver.
Yep.
And then he'll spend the advantages to pass some boosts around. So 2 boosts out there for whoever wants it, for the next person.
Bunker is just going to kind of...
Oh, I didn't actually use Macron's boost. What was it, 2 boosts, Macron?
1. Okay. 1 for 4 rounds.
Of course.
I feel nothing.
Well, I mean, Bunker wants to get himself in front of all these guys before they attack, so he's going to kind of, like, advance, holding his repeating blaster low and just, like, spraying as he moves up. So he's going to use 2 maneuvers just to move, basically, all the way up into short. Oh, yeah, he's at long, so he's getting to medium, right?
Yes.
Okay. So medium. It's going to auto-fire. 2 boosts for Maiden, right? It can still pass those, and then 1 for Macron. Okay, yeah, we'll just see what happens here.
Okay, which ones are you targeting?
Ooh. All of them.
Oh, okay. Well, you can spread them around however you want.
Yeah. So that'll be...
Yeah, and you have 3 shots that you could fire.
Oh, wait, I also have accurate 1 on this because of the augmented barrel. So.
Nice.
Oh, ah! All of those boosts.
Oh, gosh!
You may as well have not rolled those boosts.
Oh, it's okay, though. I get 3 advantages. But, so that'll be 16 pierce 1.
On
all
of them,
3
yeah?
of them. Yeah. Okay.
Nicely done.
Oh, so, Brandon, the 7 pierce 2 didn't go through, right?
7 pierce 2 did not go through. They have 10 soak, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Aiden's definitely got to get up close for this.
Yep. So you can see you blast off pieces of them as the blasts hit. Okay. Now I have an NPC, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So Ragesh is in front of Thomas, right?
Yeah.
So this one tunnel worm, back from where it is right now, its tail whips out at Ragesh.
Okay. And, you know, because he's trying to protect Thomas, he's not going to coordination dodge this. He can't risk that tail, you know, missing him and hitting the kid. So I will take a strain to upgrade it once with dodge.
Okay.
So you're not going to dodge it, but you're going to dodge it?
Well, I'm not going to coordination dodge, so... I'm just trying to move my body instead of flipping around.
It's going to aim, and it's going to upgrade. Any defenses?
Yeah, actually. 2, actually, yes. 2 defense.
Whoosh. So that connects for 11 damage.
All right. Any pierce?
No, but it knocks you down, and you're concussed.
All right. Down concussed.
If that was 11 damage to Ragesh, he's got some nice soak going on.
He's got a lot of hit points, so.
Robot man.
He's 31 HP.
So, who's next? Another NPC.
Dara.
Dara will run.
She's just gonna leave.
Nope, she's gonna run up there. So that's medium. And running to medium will take two maneuvers, yes?
Yes, and if you fire at either of these, you get your quick strike boosts.
Yep. So. Okay. Yeah, so how much strain do I get for doing the two maneuvers?
Two strain. Yeah, it's always two strain for the second maneuver.
Okay, cool.
Unless you're Aiden.
Oh, yeah. Okay, she is going to do guns blazing and called shot. So, yeah, that's five strain. Okay. I am gonna boost, so I get extra one of those, and I need one of them. So here we go.
Nice damage.
That's a lot. Nice.
That is 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That's 17, and I am going to activate dual shots. Sorry, twin linked.
Okay, are you going to do the top one or the middle one?
The one that hasn't gone. Which one?
Both of them haven't gone.
But the top one is staggered, so you might want to go for the middle one.
That one's staggered, so I'll go for that one.
The middle one?
Yeah, okay, the middle one.
And then the one on the bottom had gone, that's why.
Oh, right, okay, yeah. Actually, yeah, no, sorry, yeah, the staggered one.
No, the middle one has staggered one. Go for the one that isn't staggered.
Middle one. Yeah, sorry.
Duh. Okay, so you said 17, and is that 17 for both shots, or?
12, 13,
14. Wait.
Yes.
You're at medium, right? And you're doing two shots? Should you not need,
Guns blazing.
Okay.
Yeah, I've got guns blazing, and I have the mod of paired weapons. And, also, how many do I need to crit? It says three. Okay,
So, what's the damage on the second shot?
The second shot is the same as what I've rolled, yes?
Okay, you take it down before, describe how your two blasts from a blaster pistol actually take down this huge creature.
Okay, as she runs forwards, she puts her hands on her two dragonized reapers, pulls them out, and takes one shot to the head, another shot to the same place in the head, goes through each eye socket, as if it got eyes. Well, actually, no, through the mouth,
yeah,
and goes into the brain. Completely decimates the brain.
Yep. So you see this worm screech out and then rise up to its full height above ground and then collapse backwards.
And she'll turn and say, "That's how you do it."
There's got to be a cleaner way to do that rotate, by the way.
Yeah.
So, I guess it would have been either that one or the other one, so...
Yep, I don't have any turns for the round, so...
Yeah. So, top of the round, then.
Yep.
Aiden can go again, or Ragesh, maybe, or whoever.
Ragesh is staggered.
Oh, he's staggered, so... Aiden will go, I guess. He'll move in. He's currently halfway to medium from long, so one goes to medium, and then one to short. So then he has two... He has one maneuver left, so he's set to aim. And then he'll have this accurate from his pistol. And also the boost from Macron. So... Just adversary one, right? And defense...
Yep, adversary 1, defense 2.
Okay. You know what? I'm going to use second chances because I haven't used it this encounter. And I'm going to re-roll the one with just the advantage and one of the boosts. Okay, that works out. So 6 success, so 12 damage, pierce 2 twice.
Okay,
and
bottom one or top one?
The bottom one. Oh, wait, none of them are staggered, right?
No.
But they have the same damage on them, so bottom one's closer. Why not?
Okay, so that was 12 pierce 2, you said?
Yeah, twice. And also, I believe the second one will crit. Wait, hold on. Well, if it kills it anyway, then that's fine, but...
No, it shouldn't be. So we'll move that down so you can see. Nope.
No, it wouldn't crit. He can't use both shots if he's critting, so he'll just have 3 advantage left to pass 2 boosts again.
You can't crit with 3?
No, it crits on 4.
That's silly.
What are you using?
I'm using my Lancers, because I haven't upgraded the Star Daggers yet, because I don't have all the mods I want in the thing yet. So I'm waiting until Special Modifications comes out into the editor.
Yeah. Might want to talk to... Oh, wait, no, Nog made the Star Daggers, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just waiting until I can easily trick it out all in the editor as opposed to forcing some stuff in there or whatever, so...
Monk is going to continue to spray as he runs forward, I guess. He'll soak up those boosts. He'll flip again. He's going to do the same thing. So 2 maneuvers halfway, and then move to short. Oh, no, it's just 1, because he's already a medium. Yeah, so just 1 maneuver, and then, okay, yep.
He has 1 aim.
Yeah, so he's going to take strain aim then. Basically, at short, he's going to try to be slightly in front of Rakesh. And basically motion for him to take Thomas away.
Yep.
Because he is programmed to be a hero, and that's what he's going to do. okay. There you go.
Wow. Okay. He's definitely a hero.
Yeah. That's going to be more than enough to finish them both.
Yeah, 18 first one to both of them.
Yeah.
And the second one maybe gets crit.
Oh, well, he could... Well, wait.
Yeah, you should be able to get enough shots, right?
Yeah, so he shoots one, shoots it again, and then shoots the other one for the other damage to finish it. So yeah.
Yep.
So one of them's getting hit for 18 pierce 1 twice, and the other one's just getting hit for 18 pierce 1.
Okay.
That works.
Yep. More than enough. So these like, siege worm larvae collapse where they are. Okay. So, you can coax Thomas back to consciousness pretty easily. It looks like he was just over his strain threshold, basically, after having to maintain the illusion for so long.
He made his cool check, and he's okay.
Oh, wait, did Bunker see the stormtroopers here?
I don't think so, actually. What you would have seen, I think you saw distortions in the light. Because the way that that misdirect really works is like it's like manipulating light, right?
It's more of a mind affecting thing. It's making someone believe they see something. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so probably does not work on droids. So yeah, he wouldn't have seen it.
Yeah. So okay. Yeah.
So as soon as Thomas is up, Rakesh is going to say, "Look, what you can do is not." Toy, it is not a game. People die because of others finding out what you did.
Particularly those you're making illusions of.
Yeah, we're going to have to come up with a story that doesn't point anything to you because no one other than the Wookiees can know about what you can do. And
so Thomas being a 6-year-old and being berated by Rakesh is like shrinking into the littlest furball that he could possibly be.
And I'll try to, soften the words just a little bit and say, how am I going to put this?
Daryl would say, what you did was very brave. Allowing the others to escape while creating an illusion of them of stormtroopers so that the worms were distracted.
Yeah, that's good. A little bad cop, good cop action there, mom and dad. So,
yeah.
But at this point, I then look at the others and just say, you know, we do know that there are plants in the Wookiee forest that are hallucinogenic, and we need to lie. We can't actually say what really happened here. So we
problem is that old lady. I mean, they'll believe that the kids were high out of their minds, but what about?
Well, the only person in right the forest. I mean, she's got bad eyesight. I mean, I'm
she
sure,
does. Yeah.
Yeah, she probably
could be foam gas.
I mean, she's an old lady. You know.
Yeah.
We'll just have to
crazy old woman.
Yeah.
Poor Beldry.
Yeah.
Okay. So do you want to talk to the Wookiees first? How do you want to go about this?
The Wookiees are already aware of his talents, right?
Well, now they are, as soon as...
Well, I mean, were they before, I guess?
The children seem to have known, and it was okay. The children that were sort of playing around with it. Okay, more Wookiees.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to ask the Wookiees and say... you know, we're willing to keep this a secret if you want to keep it a secret, but at the same time,
he's already kind of been outed to his to the rest of the adults to a degree. By
oh no, I'm saying to the adult Wookiees I'm talking to. But you know, this is a pretty big secret to the rest of the community. Totally understand if you don't want to tell them, but at the same time, with everything that all those people have been through, I actually think that Wayright would be one of the few places where. Before sensitive, but, well, no, we've got secondhand Lao. Never mind.
You know, we could always ask Saber if he could intercede and do, I don't know, a little bit of training, you know, control and stuff like that.
Well,
teach
actually,
control.
I've got a whole backpack full of Mercer grenades. Pow! No.
Here, get a. Yeah, we can offer to have.
Well, actually, isn't that the one drawback to mercy grenades that they make them forget the immediate encounter, not something that happened like days ago?
Well, I mean, I was just joking. That's why.
Okay. Well, I was just double checking because honestly, I don't know.
Just blanket the town in them.
Yeah, because that seems like would be a great solution for both our missions. Like, carpet bomb the place with mercy grenades. Am I going to bring up that? Now that Thomas has shown his power, he can't stay with just the Wookiees. We need to bring Gristle, Erdo, and Saber in on this.
Wesher actually nods and says that before the Clone Wars, a child of his village was actually taken by the Jedi.
Oh, crap. I just saw that guy's name a minute ago.
Benji, right?
The same one. Yeah.
Benji, yeah.
Coolest lightsaber in the series.
Mm-hmm.
I forget what it looked like, actually. I gotta find it now.
It had wood, like, inlaid on the metal.
Ah.
And, so, Wesher says that Thomas... is a treasure of the Wookiee people, what that remains. And he instructs Shorbecca and gives Shorbecca an order, actually, that Shorbecca is to protect Thomas wherever you guys may view that he needs to be taken to be trained.
Or perhaps, instead of perhaps being taken...
Yeah.
Instead of being taken to be trained with Saber, Saber could come here and
that's a nice thought.
Train in private.
Whatever you think is best for your.
Is worried about another incident.
I'm also would bring up the concern that that may give up Ultra Mountain's location if we have someone constantly going to and fro.
Well, I think what he's kind of saying is, like, for us to actually take him with us, So.
Well, yeah, I'm bringing this up to counter the just have ferry someone to from the Wookiee community back to train him.
Maybe just maybe just bring him with us for a while, and send him back afterwards. Maybe.
When he's got better control.
Yeah, when we think he's ready.
What Dara would say is, do you have a landing pad here for a ship?
In the forest? No, the Wookiees don't.
There's a clearing, I'm sure.
There is a landing pad back at Wayright, yes?
No, what I meant was in the woods, you know, clearing.
Not really, no. I mean, the Wookiees chose the densest part of the forest in order to support their village that they built into the trees.
Because Dara said that she could always ferry across, as in supplies, you know, medicines, etc.
Well, they already get that from her.
Yeah.
But yeah, Ragesh is going to say that he thinks that it's probably a better idea that Thomas come with us and learn better control, and when he's deemed safe by our Force Sensitives to come back, he can.
Yeah. Weshir gives a nod to that and then looks to Shorbeka and says, this is a duty for you to protect what little remains of the Wookiee people.
Dara would step up and say, if you wish, I could be part of that, if you wish. Just to be there when you need someone to talk to.
I think what Rushier is really talking about is actual protection.
Yeah, she could do that as well.
Yeah, I mean, he assumes that by letting the broker's agents have Thomas, that most of you would be on the lookout, but he's giving a special mission for Shorbeka to be sure that Shorbeka has, maintaining
a duty, if you will, or an obligation.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Wookiee duty.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. But Weshir thanks you and says that he knows that everyone in the organization, he doesn't say the broker directly, will have the best interests of Thomas in mind. And he thanks you for saving him and for giving him an opportunity to actually learn to control.
Aiden will nod and say, "We'll be sure to bring him back as soon as he's ready."
And Wesher says, "And what will we tell Wayride?"
So we're going to lie. You need to tell me about the most potent hallucinogenic plants that you've got. I know that we've talked about some before, and I can't remember the names, but we need to get those, and we're going to tell people that the kids were high, as everyone already knows that they are, and they took some of those, or they didn't realize that they did, and saw that as a vision, and with the elderly woman, well, we'll just have to let people make assumptions on her just seeing things.
Do you want to flip a destiny? I'll give you something.
Sure.
Something I forgot to... this was a detail that I meant to give out, but... So Macron, whenever she was telling you the story about seeing Pelion, it was... She was collecting firewood. So something you may add on to that is that some of this herb may have gotten onto the firewood that she was burning inside of her house or something.
Yes.
She still used a wood-burning stove.
All right, will do.
Okay. So with that story, you go back to Dox. Do you actually tell Dox the truth?
Oh, yeah. I mean, of course. And we tell him this is why we have to keep it a secret. I mean, he knows.
Mm-hmm. Does he know, Ben?
Oh, no, I meant he knows that. I meant in terms of trust, like, that we can trust each other.
Yeah, we don't really hide much from him, if anything, do we?
Yeah, and so, I'll let you react the way Dox would react to that.
I don't know. I mean, just knowing that there's a force sense. I mean, to him, I guess, it would be a matter of time. Like, he would have thought there would be a matter of time before it turns out that someone around here is force sensitive. But I think you would know all along that it's probably bullshit that there were Imperials here anyway. Because if he thought there was any credible threat of there being actual stormtroopers in the forest, he would have been out there himself hunting them like animals. So
yeah, hopefully I hinted at that at the beginning that Dox really did not believe it at all.
Right.
So okay, yeah. So with that, you give your official investigative report to the village. Some of them grumble a bit, but it seems to fly for the time being, at least. Everything seems to go back to normal.
Yay.
So that's Shadow the Broker 112, Phantom Shadows.
Awesome.
A little more of a ominous title. Okay, I guess we can talk XP until the lunch, next lunch.
It's like if anyone saw, was it Django Unchained?
Oh, yeah.
I still haven't seen that yet. I really need to.
Yeah.
Okay, so base 10 XP, let's get your nominations for things, guys.
I mean, I'd say dispersing the mob is probably worth some.
Yeah, you got it into the third round, or you got it before the third round, which would have been the last, and then whatever the balance would have been. So I'm going to get +3 for that.
So. Okay.
Nice.
Informing Weshev the other rookie, still can't remember his name.
Shulbar.
That's the one. Was amping up resistance incites more or less allowing people to inciting to riot.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, sure.
Pointing out the arms dealer is probably not the best person to listen to when you're trying to make a rational decision.
Okay, yeah, so that's another +1, so I think we're at 15.
Okay.
I mean, convincing the kids that, you know, it's okay, give us some information, and I think both sides, just we...
Yeah, +1 for both sides, talking to the old lady and talking to the
17
kids.
Now?
17, yeah.
Macron PI.
And saving Thomas. Like, yeah, saving no the damage kids. To him.
Yeah.
And no one got swallowed. That was a possibility.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Got swallowed.
Yeah. That didn't happen.
Yeah, so I'll bring it up to 20 and lock it there. Nominations
for...
Oh,
I thought we were at 18. I mean, not that I'm complaining, but...
Well, just added 3 for that, I think.
Oh, wow. Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, to the end there for the points you guys made. So 20, Merp, most interesting role player.
I'll nominate Macron.
I'll count out with a Rogesh nomination.
Man, I'm torn. They were both really good. Macron kind of, I think I'm gonna go Macron for MVP. So yeah, Rogesh.
Rogesh.
Okay. Is that the votes in? Can we get votes?
I mean, I think that's already a majority for Rogesh.
Yeah, that's 3. Me, Dara, and Dan.
Okay.
I mean, me, Dean, and Dan.
Okay. So Rogesh for Merp and MVP.
I mean,
Macron. I mean,
Macron,
the interjections.
Yeah.
Those interjections basically ran the entire conversation.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's a social battle, and you have a character that's built for that, so that's really... So, you got to flex your social muscles there for a second.
Yeah, big time. Beast.
Yeah. Okay, so Macron for MVP. Obviously, I had a bit of a setup for the mission that wouldn't really play into Dara's family, so I didn't get to touch that at all. And duty didn't trigger either, so... Yeah, I think we can lock it down there. Any questions from anyone?
Not a question, but a comment. But thanks for doing this with such short notice.
I really appreciate
that. One question. Is there any kind of compensation from Dox for helping? Just out of curiosity.
Well, we can ask Ben, actually.
He's not usually very stingy, so...
Yeah,
because he knows what it's like to not be paid for doing stuff as an agent. So
maybe 500 credits each? Is that reasonable?
I'd say maybe even 1,000.
Okay.
Cool.
I mean, he's the governor, so...
Governor.
Yeah, so 1,000 credits each.
Yeah, like none of us asked because he's a friend, but,
He already had payment for you whenever you arrived.
Out of curiosity, how different would things have been have we not been able to quell the angry mob?
They would have gone after the Morphoid.
Oh. Huh.
They would have gone to the conclusion that the Morphoid was causing it, actually. And you would have had to deal with them trying to attack the Morphoid.
And then we would have never found out who really caused it, I guess, potentially.
Poor Morphy.
Yeah, I think you guys understood immediately once you talked to the kids that the Morphoid can't transform into three different people.
Yeah.
So...
All right, cool stuff, though. That was good.
Yeah.
Yep, thank you. So we'll see you guys next week for Shadow the Broker 113.
Dun, dun, dun.
And
it's crazy. It's gotten so high.
Yeah.